I've never understood why people sell their soul to aid and abet a criminal.
Dear Harvey.
Rose McGowan is the most prominent force behind the Me Too movement.
Today, Lady Justice is staring down a super predator.
At just 22, she shot to fame after landing a leading role in the blockbuster movie Scream. The young and ambitious actress was bound to become Hollywood's next big star, but also Weinstein's next victim. At the 1997 Sundance Film Festival, he coerced Rose to a business meeting at his hotel, where he allegedly raped her.
Give us a sense of the toll that it takes on you, the suffering after an attack like that.
Well, your life is really never the same. You know, you want it to be desperately. When you do get attacked, there's a huge part of you that's like, can we just go back to the hour before this happened where I was me?
Weinstein is obviously, in your mind, the lowest of the low, but all those people that are...
I think they're lower.
Honestly?
I do. I've always thought people that are complicit, whether through silence or through monetary gain, especially through monetary gain, what is wrong with you? He has set up a whole life and a company as a front for a rape factory, a human trafficking factory. And he got a lot of people there to help him with his big rape fantasy and his rape machine, right? I think it'd be best for everyone if he just ceased to exist, however that happens.
Seth Friedman has made a living operating in the shadows.
There is an adrenaline rush. There is a kind of sense of mission that I've got.
He's a gun for hire, a spy digging for dirt on behalf of powerful, cashed-up clients, oligarchs, business barons, but most notably, the notorious Harvey Weinstein.
Not there to think about, is he a nice guy? Is he a good dad? Does he pay his taxes? This was another job. This was a big executive with a problem.
The first rule of being a spy is that no one knows you're a spy. But in the widespread coverage of Weinstein, Seth's cover has been blown. And now he's revealing all to us about this sordid story.
When you're filling out a form and it asks your occupation, what do you put down?
These days I put spy because I might as well admit it.
Do you love your job?
I love it.
Why?
Because one, it's a natural fit for me, and also I think, you know, I don't have any moral issues with it.
In 2016, Seth was approached by the intelligence agency Black Cube and asked to conduct covert operations for Harvey Weinstein. He claims he was initially told Weinstein was investigating corporate rivals, not trying to defend himself against numerous accusations of sexual assault. Seth was given a hit list of 91 targets the Hollywood producer saw as threats, including the likes of actress Rose McGowan.
When someone's name ended up on here, what did that mean?
If someone's name was listed in red, they're like a top priority target. But basically the idea was go through the list and try and find out who is saying negative things, because he wants a heads up as to what he thinks is going on. He wants it confirmed.
Black Cube certainly knows how to hunt a target. The firm is run by several former heads of Mossad, Israel's elite spy agency. Seth himself was also previously a member of the Israeli Defense Forces.
It's not beat around the bush, Black Cube. It's run by some pretty hard bastards.
It certainly is. I wouldn't want to be on the wrong side of them, but luckily, well, hopefully I'm not.
It's the dark arts, essentially, isn't it?
It is the dark arts. That are we in agreement on. I mean, like, of course it's the dark arts, because that's the nature of spying.
Black Cube agents are suspected of intimidating dozens of Harvey Weinstein's accusers. The operatives, in some cases, befriending the women, even pretending to be from victims' support groups, with the intel then being sent straight back to Weinstein. Seth's tactic was simple. The seasoned spy would assume the role of a newspaper reporter, a job he genuinely once had, and then trick his targets into opening up.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Oh, hi, thanks for calling back.
That's the exact approach he took when he called Rose McGowan.
And I was just hoping I could maybe talk to you about a piece that we're doing.
So do you have specific questions? Or?
I said to her, like I said to pretty much everyone, I'm interested in doing a piece on life in Hollywood now, in 2017, whenever, compared to life in Hollywood when people started out, say, 20, 30 years ago.
That's straight out deception.
In what sense? Like, I mean, what deception is in, do I have an ulterior motive?
Well, you weren't working on a piece.
What if I then, let's say I did publish a piece a month later on life in Hollywood, but I was still passing that information back. Is that still straight out deception?
I mean, you're claiming that you're writing a piece. I mean, it's just fanciful.
Yeah, that's a cover. I wasn't writing a piece, but I said that I was because that's a way in. And then if you were looking back at your younger self...
Rose, unfortunately, walked right into the trap.
Well, that's because I actually have a signed document from the time of the attack.
She trusted Seth and opened up to him in this 75-minute phone call, including detailing her abuse by Harvey Weinstein. Information that Seth then sent straight back to the boss.
Would you describe yourself as a moral person?
What does a moral person mean? I mean, against what benchmark is morality set? As long as I can live with what I do, and I've never had a sleepless night thinking, oh, that's so evil what I do or have done.
But there were alleged victims of sexual assault who, many cases where they say that these double agents came to them, of which you were one of them, and it did muddy the waters for them, and it made them hesitant then to come forward and speak out because they didn't know who they could trust. And like it or not, that silences people.
There's one person who says that. That's Rose McGowan.
Black Cube came after you personally.
Yeah, yeah.
What toll did that take on you?
I think it shaved years off my life. I think them coming after me spun my brain and still does in a way that's fractured a part of me that I don't think will ever fix. But these are people that hurt people, and that's their job. Their job is to hurt other people, so, you know, I hope they're proud at night.
Rose McGowan was targeted by Black Cube because she was seen as a threat.
I feel scared here. I don't feel safe, you know?
Like many of Weinstein's rape accusers, Rose was intimidated into signing a non-disclosure agreement, paid $100,000 to stay silent.
I went to a therapist in New York for trauma issues, and she suggested I get a puppy.
Almost two decades after her attack, in the wake of Me Too, Rose finally garnered the strength to share her story. But she quickly learned it wasn't just Weinstein she was taking on.
In your mind, you're at war.
Yes. I have been, ever since I got raped.
But the thing with Harvey Weinstein is he has an army behind him.
He has a real one. But he has an army of spies, lawyers, minions. It's an army of the complicit, of people that they're going to the mat for a serial rapist because he makes movies that win an Oscar? What?
Do you see it just basically as evil?
Yes, it is evil. It's literally a web of evil.
It's like she's got a screw loose. She's not hero and I'm villain unless you, in a very childlike, someone has to be good and someone has to be bad. I mean, her saying I do the bidding of evil, still I'll probably sleep tonight, I reckon, yeah. You cannot take that from me.
My small reprieve's your heart of gold. Rose McGowan continues to inspire the army brought to life by the Me Too movement.
We are free. We are beautiful, we are strong, and you will never take that from us. The only thing
worth fighting for. And she's adamant that even if Weinstein wins this battle, they'll be making sure he still loses the war.
And he will be tied up in courts for a very, very long time, hopefully as long as he lives.
If the justice system won't hold him to account, you will.
Oh, I'll be there. He unleashed the hounds of hell on me. I've got some powerful allies, too.
Hello, I'm Sarah Abo. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.